Adobe Creative Cloud plugins and integrations.
Saving time and having fun are both very important things while designing. Therefore, at YummyGum, we created Confetti for Adobe XD, making natural-looking confetti effects a total breeze. The plugin features many options in the panel for creating your own custom confetti. Let me show you. The columns and the rows can be utilized in order to define the amount of particles generated on the X and Y axis, respectively. So for a particle this size, 7 columns and 5 rows seems like a fitting amount. Let's try it out. Randomizing the opacity is also a fun way to create more diversity in your confetti design. The percentage slider defines the range of the opacity, meaning that placing the slider on 20%, like so, will result in a 20 to 100% range. We can try that out here while using the same columns and rows, and you'll get this effect. Adding a randomized rotation might also be a nice way to spice up your confetti, especially for angular shapes. So if you were to grab your object like so, and select the randomized rotation, all of these options will stack, by the way, meaning that more settings will add more variation to your end product. So click create, and you'll have an effect like so. Setting a randomized skill is probably one of the most effective ways of creating depth in your confetti. So setting the minimum range to 50% will make sure that no particles will end up smaller than half its original size. Vice versa for the maximum percentage. So in this case, I don't want it to end up larger than it originally is. Let me use this pink circle as an example. Now, since this object is bigger than the ones we've been working with so far, it will take up more space and therefore protrude outside of the artboard here. So let's undo this action and decrease the amount of particles that we wanted to create and maybe make it a little smaller as well, like so. Now, what we can also do is enable the depth of field blur. This makes it so that the smaller the generated objects are, the more blur it receives. Let's try it out here. I'll make the original shape a little smaller. And let's create it. And it'll create this nice effect here. Now, the final thing we can play around with is to randomize some colors. So let's insert some colors here. I'll just copy paste them in. All right, let's just redo this one and just try it with this. And as you can see, it has used the different colors that we've selected here. If you're interested in learning more or installing the plugin, check out our website on xdconfetti.com.